My name is Kevin Teichman, and I'm a senior science advisor in the EPA Office of Research and Development. I've worked at EPA for 33 years, and I've seen firsthand the impactful difference that scientists and engineers at EPA have made to protect human health and the environment in our nation. A great example of this is particulate matter, both indoors and out. Particulate matter are the microscopic solids and aerosol droplets that can so easily get into our lungs because they are small. The sources of particulate matter include smoking, vehicles, power plants, wildfires, and other sources. I was fortunate to work on EPA's environmental tobacco smoke assessment, and that assessment was the first assessment to show that somebody else's smoking was impacting your health. Although EPA could not regulate indoor air, we were able to contribute to no smoking policies, first in federal buildings, then airplanes, in restaurants and public spaces. Over my career, I also have been fortunate to work on the national ambient air quality standards for particulate matter. And as we learn more about the effects of exposures to smaller particles, that standard changed. This has all been possible because scientists at EPA have contributed to a better understanding of particulate matter sources, exposures, health and welfare effects, and control technologies. This science has helped protect people across the nation from heart and lung disease, from heart attacks and respiratory illness. And as I look back, I am very proud of the contributions EPA and in particular Office of Research and Development scientists and engineers have made to informing impactful policies that protect the American public, protect the environment, both indoors and out in the case of particulate matter.